Welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I am the Amethyst Lunatari. Wow. I thought we had 6 hit points left. We have 4. Might die again. I don't know. This is an interactive Let's Play where at the end of the episode you get to choose what choice there is to make going forward into the next. And last episode I presented a list of spells to choose from, and it was unanimous that we cast the sap spell, which is caused depression, I believe. Yeah, this pleasure, supposedly is pleaser, but he talks weird. Nagamente. I don't know how you say that either. I don't know how he would manage to say it. That's his he's a torturer, I guess. And possible executioner as well. Now that you are close, you can see the machine in all its sick glory. There are no obvious weaknesses or mercies. The sight of it fills you with dread. Nagamente secures you into place, but he fails to notice your free hand. The sphere hovers above you, but it is lowering. Looking up would just waste time. Screaming really wouldn't do much good. He'd probably enjoy that. So we're going to try to cast a spell, which will be sap. Luckily, it was unanimous, because I only got 2 votes last time. What the hell, guys? Cause depression. Requires 1 stamina out of our 3. This is 25% of our current stamina we're losing here. Don't know if that did much good. You weave the enchantment. Nagamente sighs. Plumpish-ish, he remarks. No one relish. Respects what I dush. But it's not clear if this is the spell's influence or not. He continues his work with as much enthusiasm as before. The pleasure creeps closer. Nagamente does a small jig as the sphere begins to descend toward you. Alright, let's give him a giant. I kind of like that idea. I think that was one of the choices. The only problem is, which one is giant? I think I had these written down. Or I don't know if I... Yob, okay. The other choices, good choices, were teleportation, which could work, could backfire. And was that it? I just had the 3. I'm going to try Yob, since we know that will summon a giant. Hopefully there's room in this space for the giant. This will not remove any stamina, which is a good thing. Cool. You pull a giant's tooth from your pack and throw it on the ground, casting your spell across it. The tooth erupts into a column of smoke from which a towering giant steps out. Sweet. The giant materializes, stooping in the lower room. Order it to stomp Nagamente. That's a good choice. Do we only have a choice of one? Because we're in the thing, right? Right. Is he controlling this thing, or is it of its own free will now? Because otherwise, he continues his work. Okay, so it looks like he's controlling it, I think. Because I would like to get out of this thing and stop him. The sphere begins to descend. You know what? If I have it crushed, Nagamente, I'm afraid that this thing will actually still begin descending towards us and kill us, torture us to death, something like that. It's not going to take much to do. We only have 3 stamina. Order it to destroy the machine. You cry for help, and the giant reaches out and crushes the pleasure in 1 fist. Nagamente brandishes his whip, but the giant simply picks him up and flings him across the room, where he crumples. Nice! His work done, the giant disappears. Look around first. You look around. The room is calm and quiet. Then you notice a set of slightly bloodied keys lie on the table, just within reach. I'd say that giant saved the day, yes. Oh, we were looking for keys, weren't we? Stretching out your fingertips, you work the keys towards you on the table and manage to lift the ring between loose, shaking fingers. Unlock the manacles. With one hand free, it is the work of a moment to free your other hand and then your legs. You look around the nasty room. Various evil-looking devices hang on the walls, along with the remains of those they were used upon. Cabinets line the walls. Okay. Cool. I'm hoping we can find some food in this place. Food is really scarce here. Gotta say. Oh, I got stuff. I got some gold. I mean, 48. You look around the cabinets lining the room and find some gold the ogre had squirreled away. I'm not sure what we were at before. We did have plenty. He also has an impressive collection of herbs and bandages, including several vials of blimberry potion and a psychroflax herb. Let's take the vials. You take 5 vials of potion from the rack. It seems Nagamante liked to keep his prisoners alive as long as he could. We can drink this at any time, so I'm going to look at the psychroflax in case that would go away. The psychroflax herb used to be... the psychroflax herb used to be a frequent sight around Cantapani, just outside the Shamutanti Wall. It was munched by villagers and sightmasters alike to combat the effects of the foul air of the hills, but a few severe winters had all but wiped it out. What looks here is... What's here looks like a meager stock at best, but nonetheless it is a herb with some very effective properties, and it is worth eating immediately. Okay, good. Save the blimberry potion, eat the herb. We have 3. Okay. Was hoping we'd get more from that. Very effective. Slightly effective. You wolf down the psychroflax herb and immediately begin to feel the benefits. You have seen all you want to in the torturer's stores. Alright. So, we have blimberry potion. It's magical, isn't it? 5 doses. Let's drink 1, just in case. Alright. We should give us more than 3, but I think it's a variable. 3 to 5, or 3 to 6, possibly, something like that. You look over some of the tables and workbenches, but find nothing which is not appalling and distasteful. Only one seems notable. Pinned to one bench are 2 translucent, thin, stretched green skins. We gotta look. You look more closely until you recognize them for what they are. They are mini-mite wings. Your stomach turns a loop at the sight of them. You move quickly away. Aw. Hope that's not our friend, mini-mite. Mini-mite friend. Hmm. Low door. During the past day, you gain some maximum stamina plus 5. What's maximum? That's true. We were at 19, weren't we? Sweet. Gained some gold, plus 5, reached the inner fortress of Mampang, and met Nagamante the Terrible. The Archmage is still looking for you. Is he really? I thought he left. I thought he left to go back to, you know, our homeland, to conquer them. You hurry away down the corridor, skirting around the hanging flail. That was good news. Good thing. We were looking for keys, maybe for this gate? I forget. You breathe a deep sigh of relief. You have escaped the foul lair of Magamante. Best to never return. I don't see why we would. There's a doorway to your left, and the alley itself runs out of sight to the right. The door down to the city is locked. It must be morning by now. You've been awake all night and are weaker for it. The alleyway leads off around the mountain, but there is no way back over the palisade. Oh, do we... We lost more stamina. Were we at 8 and we went to 11? Now we're at 9. I guess because we were awake all night. We didn't sleep. I don't mind sleeping. Wait. I want to go down this way now. I can't go that way. You make your way along the alley, looking about furtively. Luckily, you pass no one. This area seems quite dead. The air is cold. You pass the door to the empty turret room. You had best not hang around out in the open. Now, I'm trying to go back down this way. There's a doorway to your left, and the alley itself runs out of sight to the right. The door down to the city is locked. The air moves a little around you, still icy but fresh. The alleyway leads off around the mountain, but there is no way back over the palisade. You're kidding, I can't go down? I got keys from him. Oh, I didn't? Ah. Wait. Necklace of a goblin. Prison cells. No, I guess that was just... Okay. I figured one of the keys on that keyring might have been for this, but... I guess we're stuck. I wanted to go back and see these other towers. Sadly. I don't know if we can. Alright. Let's talk to these bird guys again. The reason I basically passed them by is I wanted to go check out the rest of the college, the towers. The College of... whatever. College of Magic. You return to the empty turret chamber. Time to move on. Okay, no. Yeah, the wind begins to whisper around. The alley turns slightly here, following the curve of the cliff. At the far end, you spot two birdmen guards standing by an iron door. They have either not noticed you or are paying no attention. Another narrow door is on the right, a little further along the alley. It would be a good idea not to stand out in the open. You head towards the next door in the alleyway. The guards at the far end of the alley take no notice. You'd best not hang around. Let's take another blueberry juice. I don't like being in single digits right now. Let's see if I can talk to these guards again. Only the guarded iron door remains. Beyond the iron door, you can make out movement in the yard beyond. Oh, I can't revisit them? My god, I've burned so many bridges here. You approach the iron door at the alley's end. The two birdmen guards stiffen at your approach, gripping their halberds more tightly. Greetings, you say. What do you want? The bird maid says, clipping her words. Does this door lead to the central tower? You ask. Not for you. Guards only. Let me pass. Your tone stops them in their tracks. Why? Who are you? You let me through before. Then you shouldn't have trouble convincing us again, replies the birdman. Now who are you? I'm a monk. She laughs. Then back to the monastery with you. She continues to laugh even as she slams the butt of her halberd into your groin. Ouch. Sending you flying backwards. You land on your back, the impact forcing the air from your lungs. You open your arms to cast a spell, but the bird maid prances forward to step on your wrist. This is a fortress of sorcerers, she clucks. Don't think I can't recognize magic. They really need a good proofreader, you know. I found so many errors in these chapters. The bird maid holds the blade of her halberd to your neck. Her companion rouses himself, rubbing his now cracked beak. What? What happened? What happened to the companion? His now cracked beak? I did not crack his beak. Or put him to sleep, or whatever the hell. They truss you up and toss you through the iron door into the courtyard beyond. Alright, well this is where I wanted to go. Oh, well we're bound and gagged. You are dragged by your ankles by two guards who mutter about the trouble caused. They gossip to passing companions about you. The tale of your exploits will soon spread through Manpang. This will make it more difficult to blend in from now on, should you escape. Try to bribe them? You attempt to bribe them, offering rewards and fabulous riches, but through the gag is little more than the mummery of an idiot. The guards ignore you. Hopelessly, you're dragged into the office of the commander of the guard. Well, we're old buddies. Him and I. We've been in here before. You are dragged to the commander's office. To the guards he asks, why have you dragged this vagabond in here? Don't waste my time. To the dungeons? A guard asks, but the commander shakes his head. Don't waste a space. He gestures to the door and you are rudely thrown out. But your lady companion. I can tell you more. Wait. Back to the courtyard. Am I still being... You emerge from the commander's doorway. You are into the hottest hours of the day, and yet this place is still cold. The brooding tower looms above you. An iron door leads south out of the courtyard next to the commander's door. The great steps call to you. Well, okay. Apparently we're not trussed up anymore. Seems he did us a favor then. That's good. He tried to make it look good, you know, for everybody, but he did free us, or cause us to be freed. You step out into the center of the square, nervous at how exposed you seem. The sun is beginning to lower and the air begins to cool. Thick, oily smells drift from a building to the north, but the most impressive sight here is the deep, towering flight of steps that leads up towards a door in the inner tower itself. On the other side of the yard is a large block of wood. Look at the wood. The block of wood is crisscrossed with incisions and stained a deep purple color. Its use is clear enough. Is it for chopping people's heads off? A patrol of guards tramps across the square and through the iron door to the south. This close to the steps, you can see there are wide black slabs of stone carved with ornate symbols. They rise steeply enough that one could not run up them, and a shorter woman than you might have to scramble. No one goes near them. There's no time to waste. Within a month of walking, you have finally come in sight of your goal. The great sealed Throben doors stand before you at the top of the stairs. See if we can get some food. We have plenty of gold to spend. Not sure what else we could spend it on other than some more food. Because the blimberry juice doesn't give us much. And we've already used, well, basically half of it. An odd half. The wind picks up as the evening draws on. It will be dark soon. You approach a large, noisy building. It is the guards' mess hall. The building is large, with one side open to the elements. Inside, tables are packed with guards of all stripes. Beastmen, orcs, and humans all hunch over bowls of stew. They are also scattered around the mess hall, staggering with drink. Serving goblins rush to and fro, avoiding the kicks and jeers of guards. You could try entering the mess hall, but it would be walking into a viper's nest. Too bad, we're only 17 minutes in. I would leave this... You know what? Yeah, let me take one more blimberry juice. Let's take our chances in there in the viper's nest. I want to get some stew. You walk up to the hall. A sharp-eyed guard frowns at you. Now wait, she says. Are you not... But you are. Everyone, it's the Annalander. She strolled right in to see us. Hearing her cries, many leap up from their tables, reaching for their weapons. A crowd of guards rush toward you. You cannot hope to defeat them in combat. Casting a spell. Don't think they're going to believe me. Can't hope to defeat them in combat. Run. I guess up the stairs. We still have to figure out how to get through the Throben door still. Which will, you know, if they're in chase, I don't know if we can get away from them. Cast a spell. Who's laughing, damn you? Oh, yeah. Lightning? Create a shield. Good idea. If I really want to fight all of them, which I don't, actually. In general, it's a good idea. I can't see the... Okay. Create an invisible wall. Cause fear. I think I like that. So far we're going with fear. Lively dancing. Actually, we'll do that. Lively dancing. Slowness. We just got S. Depression. Clone the caster. Did I do this one? Slowness, yeah. Alright. What is this? Is this fear? I want the... Yeah, Jake. Dance for me, fools! Consulting the constellations overhead, you bind the spell, pulling out your bamboo flute and starting to play. There's a moment when you wonder if the spell can work on such a large crowd, but it would appear this is a crowd inclined towards dancing already, as they quickly break out into a stomping, wheeling dance that sprawls into the mess hall. What if I keep playing? You keep playing, and the sight and sound is like nothing you have seen on your travels so far. The guards dance as though they have never in their lives danced before, as if nothing in their lives to follow mattered either. Let's slip away, then. I don't want to press it. I don't know how long the spell on the enchantment on the flute lasts for, so... They are so keen on their dancing, in fact, that it is easy enough for you to slip away, and the stamping of their own feet is enough rhythm to keep them all moving. Oh, well. I just wanted some stew, damn it. I guess it's too late for that. Was it really that funny? Outside the mess, the silence of the mountains descends. And they're dancing. A few guards march this way and that. Clouds rumble as they roll across the dimming sky. Soon it will be dark once more. You move away from the mess hall door. Yeah, steps. Alright, guys. You make your way to the base of the great steps that lead up to the Sorcerer's Spike. The steps are wide and central. You have a view across the whole of the guards' courtyard and are equally visible. You lift your eyes upwards to the famous Throben Doors that protect the Archmage from Mampang, or the other way around, perhaps. You have been told they are guarded by spells. You steel yourself for great danger. I would cast a protection from magic, which I believe is MAG. Yes, alright. Good idea. Just want to see what other options there might be. There might be something valid here. See the future, do that. You sit cross-legged on the ground and put your palms on the orb. You bind the stars into a pattern around you and everything changes. You are standing at the top of the steps, your hand on the handle of the door. It is burning hot. Wait and watch. You wait and watch as the hand on the door handle lifts away and opens to the side. Magic is being summoned and slowly the fire inside the door handle fades away. The vision seems to snap shut, and you find yourself back by the steps once more. This is a minor tongue twister here. The vision seems to snap shut. I will not say that 5 times fast. It sounds like a fire is burning, you know. Alright, so... The door handle is burning hot, so another reason to cast that spell. This is... Sense Danger. Could be good in general. Cause depression on what? Invisibility cannot do. Talk with animals. I don't know if there's any animals here. Oh, create a tower? No. It could be a viable thing. I could, you know, make a tower to reach across next to the other tower, like we did before inadvertently. Cause teleportation. There's no need for that. Lightning. Alright. Yeah, let's try this. You craft the spell and a familiar voice begins to speak to you. The voice warns you that the doors are sealed by locks of offensive magic, then fades before it can offer any further advice. Well, we knew that. Alright, let's cast our magic. Magical defense. I've only used this once before, but it was effective then as well. Protect from magic. Reaching up to the stars, you create the magic and a veil of magical protection shimmers into place around you. Your heart is in your mouth. The inner sanctum lies within reach. You make your way one by one up the enormous steps. The tower looms above you like never before. Each step is carved with a word in the oldest tongue, spilling out a message for those who approach the dark heart of Mampeng. The message is spelled out one pictographic word at a time, one per step. Those who climb must comprehend. Enter, or else, ne'er descend. The symbols chosen are unusual. They are all the same, viewed from either direction. Those who climb must comprehend. Enter, or else ne'er descend. Meaning once you get inside, you can't go back? Seems to be the way of this anyway. I can't go back into the town anyway. At least not that I could find. So let's keep climbing. You steady your nerve and continue to climb. About halfway up, you are arrested by a shout from below. You! Where are you going? Run for it. You break into a run, leaping up the steps two at a time. The guard who has shouted races forwards, but he does not dare put foot on the staircase. From below, he shakes his fist. I'll ask you again, sister, the guard calls up. Where do you think you are running to? Are you drunk? I don't have an option to ignore him. I believe I am lost. Then I've caught you just in time. Get down from there as fast as you can. Those are the Throben Doors. They're murder. They are trapped? A thing isn't a trap if everyone knows it'll kill him, the guard replies philosophically. They're simply death itself. They open right down the throat of the Archmage. There's those that say he's no sorcerer at all, but a foul demon. I heard a rumor the Archmage was dead. It's Felix saying it, I don't know. No one's seen the Archmage in 1,000 years, or there's those who say they have, and he gestures to his shoulder, marking imaginary epaulettes. But who knows what to make of what the commanders say? But he takes a step away, clearly concerned that you might explode violently at any moment. Now get away from those doors if you know what's good for you. No one likes the smell of burning human flesh this close to the mess hall. And then he hurries away. All right, ignore the warning. Hopefully my magic protection is still active. You ignore the man's warning and continue up the steps. You have found one new clue. Which is... the commanders know the secret. It was hinted that the commander of the guard knows the way through the Throben Doors. I didn't see any such hint. All right. You stand in the dim shade by the colossal doors at the top of the stairs. Your veil of magical protection shimmers out of existence. God damn it. The sun is almost set and the sky has turned a deep purple. A silence descends as though this was a quieter corner of the city than any other. Perhaps it is something to do with the doors themselves. Certainly a heavy magic exudes from them. Damn it. This is when I need it. Is it because that man delayed me? You look around the step a little and notice something etched into the stone. It reads, Mampeng will be free. Below that are two S's entwined, and near them, two C's. Below that, two S's, two C's. S-S-C-C. Why can't I cast that spell again? Mampeng will be free. Is this maybe etched by the Birdmen? Two S's entwined, and near them two C's. They seem simple enough, the doors, if large. The large wooden panels are covered in ornate carvings. The door handle is emitting a slight red glow of heat, just as you saw in your prophetic vision. Someone has left a pack here by the door. Look at the pack. Perhaps someone else tried to open these doors once. The pack lies discarded just to one side of the steps. It is a little charred. Look under the pack. Looking at the steps on which the pack lies, there is the faintest dark mark, roughly outlining a silhouette with outstretched hand. Hopefully I don't regret this. Open the pack. Gingerly, you flip open the pack. It seems safe enough. Inside are a few glass bottles. You lift the bottles out one by one, shaking them to identify their contents. It is a set of potions. Blimberry, blessed water, fire water, and what looks like a poison. Cool. Fire water, what looks like a poison. We're going to take them. You stash each bottle and then step quickly away from the discarded pack. A door handle emits heat. So supposedly I can trace out carvings on the door and bang on the door. Only grasping the handle will damage me, I'm thinking. Oh, we have a choice to cast a spell again. I just realized that. Alright, let's look and see what we have as far as items. Did I drink three? I did. I took one more. Two measures of holy water. A potion of fire water. What's this poison? Here it is. I don't know what we'd do with that. Did I get anything else? It's pretty sweet. Weapon. Plus 6 cutlass. I like that. Alright. I don't see the sense of banging on the door. Like someone's really gonna let us in. Trace out the carvings on the door. The carvings are of obscene, distorted figures, perhaps once beautiful, but now warped and bent by fire. In the center is a single vertical stroke. I, or one. Like that rune. Glyph one. In the burnt tower. Makes sense. Glyph two is the Tower of Statues. Petrification. Glyph 4 is Tower of Skeletons. Alright. Casting a spell once again. Let's just say I have this option. I do. Okay. We have the Howl spell now. And Fireball. Oh, probably we can dispel this. Make a counter spell. Find safe passage. Hover in air, counter zap. Let me just see this. Yeah, we don't know what counters fireball or vice versa. Well, we don't know what vice versa is. Unknown. That's a spell we have still haven't figured out what that does. Teleportation. I don't know where it sent us, of course. Heal disease. Don't have a disease. As far as I know, anyway. Summon a goblin, which we cannot do. Wouldn't do much good anyway, unless we wanted him to turn the door. Which he would probably not be successful, he'd just die. That's easier. I feel like seeing what we'd get as a result of the Howl spell. I know it's going to waste the stamina, I just wonder what it would say. Thinking not much, but... You wind the constellations into alignment around you. A quiet voice enters your mind. There is a fire inside the door handle, whispers the voice. It cannot be quenched. The fire is magic and can only be overcome by more magic. With that, the spell fades. Okay. So the magic protection might not even be enough? Let me just... It counters something, doesn't it? It counters law, which is... read my, speak languages or something. Try this. Zob. You try to bind the enchantment, but you are missing an item that it needs, and so the spell dissipates around you. We don't have too many more options left. The only thing we have, I don't think fire would negate fire. That's just goblin. I can't even cast it anyway. I'm seeing how that would negate fire. Oops. I'm gonna cast magic protection and just see what happens. Stop. Zip. Teleportation counters gum, which is stuck in place. It's not gonna. We know what that counters. I hate when that happens. This counters. It counters lightning. I mean, maybe? I tend to think it's electrified, but I think... I mean, I guess I might as well try it, right? It looks like it's just heated up, not electrified, but maybe it is being bombarded with lightning and heated up? Oh, so it's, my instincts tell me no, that's not it, but... I'm also thinking... I mean, it might be heal disease. I don't know. You cast the enchantment and a medallion begins to glow as you rise gently up into the air. You lift the pommel of your sword and bang heavy on the door. The wood muffles the sound. It dies. No one answers. I don't think I've countered that spell. I don't think I have. I'm just hovering. Alright, let's cast our magical... Protect from magic. Looking to the constellations above, you craft the spell and a veil of magical protection shimmers into place around you. But will it be enough to protect you from the fire in the door? There's nothing for it. You reach for the handle and grasp it firmly. The response is immediate. Fire, reaching from the handle and burning up your arm. Only your spell of magical protection keeps you from igniting like a firework. But even so, you are forced to snatch your hand away moments later. Let's try Doc. Because we don't know what this counters. You cast the spell across your potion and begins to glow and fizz. Pour the potion on the door handle. The potion sizzles sharply as it slicks across the handle, but it does not boil away in moments as you might have expected. After a moment, it seems to cool. Touch the handle. You reach out and gingerly touch the door handle. The searing explosion you expect does not come. The metal is cool. It seems whatever magic was in the door has been countered, but the door is still not open. You have survived one of its traps, but surely there will be more. And sure enough, your fingers on the door handle are starting to flake with gray dust. You snatch your hand back. That's a two rune. Gray dust. So we need something that counters petrification. Tower of Statues, Glyph 2. So these glyphs, you must, I guess there's at least four of them. You look over the door Carefully, see that? Gaze working from top to bottom. The carvings have morphed a little, now showing figures in strange frozen poses. Two vertical strokes stand side by side. Two. Alright. That would counter gum, wouldn't it? Where's my little, I've not used this in quite some time. This, all my spells. Listing of spells, I got it. What is gum? Web? I mean, it's not exactly... Unless this is a spell we don't have in our spellbook. Mirror image. No. I'm looking through all the spells, so I'm just talking out loud here. Quicksand? Mud? It's not on a person, though. Petrify. The rock spell. R-O-K. We want the counter for that. We don't know the counter. Cause illusions. Requires a bracelet of bone. Create quicksand. It's not going to be that one. We know what that counters. That counters a force field. Just looked at that, yeah. Sorry, I know I'm repeating this. I'm just trying to create illusions. We don't know what that does. So, let me just start writing this crap down. Kid is... Create illusions, right? Cause stupidity. Doubt it. I think we unofficially found out what this is. Something to be able to see through illusions counters that, I believe. See the future counters DOP. Well, let's try that. You sit cross-legged on the ground and put your palms on the orb of crystal. You weave the starlight into your design around you, and everything changes. You see yourself standing in a room with an hourglass. The sands are trickling through. As the glass is turned by an unseen hand, you see a great explosion in the stars above. The vision fades. Alright. Something having to do with time? Maybe slowing. Slow? Maybe slow would slow it. If we have that as an option. The only thing I don't like about this is you go back and all the letters have changed. This is float in air. This is see the future we just did. Float in air. Foul. It's possible that gives a freeing by gravity, which is you're being freed, which is the opposite of being in prison, like petrified. So that's an option. I looked at this. This is cause stupidity. Create glue. Illusion of worship. God. Of worship. I'm thinking it's foul. So we got Kid, Dim, Foul, and God. Let's try Foul. You weave the spell, but although you complete the spell, it seems to have no effect, and you do not float into the air, as you had expected. Try the door handle. Tentatively, you reach out for the door handle, but sure enough, nothing happens. It is quite safe. Open the door. You turn the door handle, now completely safe. The door opens. Then, quite suddenly, the door shimmers and disappears from sight entirely. The passageway beyond is revealed. Illusion? This is tough, guys. I know it's going to be a little longer episode. It already is. Toss something into the passage. You grab a handful of dust from the step and toss it into the passage, but you might have expected it does not go through the opening. Instead, it bounces back from the opening and forms a rough line in the dirt where the door once stood. Okay. Force field, right? Foff? Counter Foff? We know the counter for that. Unfortunately, I can't look at it now. I'm pretty sure we'd have rune number 3, which we never found out. Oh, we have new clues. Oh, wait. The first spell that locks the Throben Doors is a spell of fire. Alright. Second spell? Spell of petrification. Can only be opened by one proficient in counter magic. Good thing I spent all that time. So we don't have glyph 3. So yeah, it is a good idea that, it is a good thing that we spent all that time finding out counter spells in the College of Magic on either side there. So let's cast a spell. Let's just see whatever counters Foff. I'm pretty sure that was it. Okay, I'd quickly look at Foff, but you know what? That's going to be in the beginning of the spellbook. Actually, we just passed it. Counters mud. Alright. So let's try mud. There's no M! Something else causing you to be bounced back. Let me just look at this. Foff is force field. Alright, so then it's not Foff. Then it's the other thing. It's possibly invisible wall. It's gotta be this. We don't know the counter for this. Oh, okay. I just want to see. It's probably not Fireball. You never know, actually. Fireball? I'm just going to write these down, because if there's nothing obvious to me, I'm just going to leave a few guys, but we'll see if I can figure this out, deduce this. I kind of want to end it here, but I don't want to leave it in the middle of just us getting halfway through the door. That's the invisible wall. I'm pretty sure that's it. I'm pretty sure that's what we have to counter then. It's possible it could be an illusion. Create explosions. I cannot do. I hope it's not something that we need an ingredient for that we don't have. Otherwise, how do we get through? Hover in air counters lightning. It's not going to be that. Counters gum. Gum is what? Web. I don't think it's going to be that either. Unless it's an invisible web. What are we talking about? Zip? Teleportation? I don't think it's that one. But I wrote it down anyway. So we know what that is. I'm not gonna leave that as an option. I'm not sure if I'm... Yeah. WHZ. This is the exploding pebbles, which we cannot do right now. Read minds. I could freely do that. Doesn't cost anything. Read minds. Cause invisibility. I can't cast that, I don't have that ring. Sun, create light. Doubt that's it. Sense danger. It's obvious danger. Might use that for a clue. Resurrect the dead. Doubt it. Sharpen blade, we cannot do. Talk all languages. Rap. That's fireball. Are we done then? Is that everything? I think that's everything. Yaz is... Yeah, I can't do that. Which was the one that had a lot of options? This one did. Resurrection. I just want to make sure I didn't miss any of them. R-E-S-R-A P and Z. Yeah. Raz. What's Raz again? Sharpen blade. We can do. Alright. I'm gonna try... I guess to read minds? Aha! Drawing the skull cap from your pack, you cast a spell. A moment later, the door is visible once more. It would seem your spell has countered the spell of invisibility that had hidden the door. Okay, so it wasn't what I thought. Now you can see it. Your hopes lift suddenly. The door to the Sorcerer's Spike of Manpang hangs a crack ajar. A good shove will open it, but you cannot help but feel there is still another trap to be overcome. There's a message on the door now that was not visible previously. We'll read it. You trace out the message on the door. Words of the most ancient tongue. I am protected by the worst force in the world. Retreat, for I will take your yesterdays and I will take all your tomorrows. I am protected by the worst force in the world. I will take away your yesterdays and your tomorrows. Huh. What's the worst force in the world? Death? Resurrection would counter death, wouldn't it? They say the doors are death. I'm kind of, certain about this. You take the vial of holy water from your pack and cast your spell. The water begins to shimmer and shine with an inner light. Pour the water on the door. You pour the glittering water over the handle of the door. It seems to soak into the wood, without any noticeable effect. Whether it has had any effect on the door is impossible to say. Do we get a hint on this? Sense danger? I don't have that. How, maybe? Find safe passage. Huh. Consulting the stars, you bind the magic. Otherwise, the spell has little effect, but for a general sense of direction that points clearly away from the door. What else can I do? Summon darkness. Cause strength requires fire water, which we do have. I can always try resurrect again. Summon a giant, which I can actually do. Talk with animals. Protect from magic. Create quicksand. That's strength. That's strength, which is going to be different from stamina, so not necessarily giving us hit points. Or stamina points, rather. Summon a goblin, which you can't do. Okay, options. Okay, here are my options. I'll try to remember to put them here again in the corner. Option A, just push open the door. Option B, cast protection from magic, push open the door. Option 3, summon a giant, have it open the door. Or try to, anyway. Option 4, cast resurrect again on the door. Those are our three or our four options, so let me know which you guys want to choose. I'm really nervous just pushing open the door, and I'm not trusting it. I mean, for all I know, it's not resurrection. Whether it has any effect on the door is impossible to say. So. The most powerful force around. The only thing I think would be death. So I'm thinking it was resurrection. That's goblin. Cause strength, unless weakness will take away all your tomorrows. Yesterday's and tomorrow's. I don't think so. Create wind. Let me try something. You turn the stars into shape around you, lifting the gale horn and blowing a loud note. You feel your sense of direction becoming confused. Around you, a wind builds and begins to push at the door, easing it a crack further open. The dark passageway beyond is now visible. I don't know. Can we just slip in then? What if I do it again? Can I do it? Craft the enchantment, placing your gale horn to your lips and playing a clear tone. The wind builds around you once more. Alright. We're gonna add option 5. I don't know, I'm gonna have to end up rolling to see what we do unless we have some kind of majority vote here. So option 5 is just to slip into the passageway now. So I can still push. You know what? I don't know. Yeah, let me know what you guys think. I'm not sure. I'd really rather not die again. I'm pretty sure if this is death here, it doesn't matter how much stamina we have, we'll die anyway, so I might as well not use any. So let me know, just change it. Let me instead of pushing open the door, option A will be slip into the passageway. Or option 1. Option 2 will be summoning a giant, having it push open the door. It's not going to be able to slip into the passageway, I don't think. So, giant pushing open the door. Option 3, casting protect from magic and slipping into the passageway. And option 4 is going to be casting resurrect on the door again. And I guess with that, I'll push open the door because I'm doing it on the door, right? So it makes sense. So let me know what you guys think. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks for voting. And endure. In enduring, grow strong. See you next week.